بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we are going to talk about the part one of basic mechanical ventilation review. Before we started, you have to be safe driver, safe doctor. What does this mean? During my fellowship time in one of the big hospital in the capital, I was new at that time actually, and I was the first responder. And I received a call from the delivery room regarding preterm 26 weeks about to deliver. This is according to them. It's about to deliver now. I told them, it's okay, sir. I am coming. I came already. The baby, I received the baby. It was not vigorous at all. So we started the neonatal resuscitation by initial steps, then post pressure ventilation, then corrective ventilation steps, then the patient need intubation, then we give him the surfactant. After we stabilize the patient, shift him to NICU. In NICU, we connect it to mechanical ventilation, then we insert UEC and UVC, we take the chest x-ray and the blood gas, we also take septic cork up and we started antibiotic. Then we call the second on call just to inform him about the case. My senior came actually and started to ask me, because the first time and first on call for me in the hospital, and he asked me, do you have certificate for mechanical ventilation? Do you have license or certificate for central line insertion? Do you have certificate for big line insertion? So I asked him, why you ask all these questions? And the baby, actually I intubate the patient, I give surfactant, I insert the UC, UVC and all of this. He told me actually our hospital, they did statistically analysis regarding the doctor intubate the baby or ventilate the baby and insertion the line and all of this. They found a doctor working in NICU without neonatal resuscitation program or NRB, without mechanical ventilation training or courses or certificate, without central line insertion certificate or big line certificate, it will be harmful than beneficial, and it will be harm. How the doctor will be harm? Because might be he doesn't understand the pathophysiology of the disease, might be he's not familiar with the mechanical ventilations, he's not trained well about the different mode of mechanical ventilations, so he can harm the patient. And he think the harm it's come from the lung only. Actually, it's come from pulmonary and extrapulmonary. Maybe actually, if you cannot understand the pathophysiology of the disease and you cannot understand the mechanical ventilations and how to deal with the sick patient on the mechanical ventilations, you can harm the patient through the pulmonary and extrapulmonary. Pulmonary, maybe the baby will be oxygen dependent, ventilator dependent, and it will end the result by chronic lung disease. And also don't think the pulmonary is extra pulmonary and the most important organ, it will be damaged the brain, might lead to brain damage and neurodevelopmental disability, intraventricular hemorrhage, BVL, and even can from ventilation, from oxygenation. Also, if you cannot handle the oxygen very well, can harm the patient through the free radicals, lead to intraventricular hemorrhage and retinopathy of prematurity, ROP, and BVL, periventricular leukomalacia. So for this, we need to be more familiar with the different modes and all of this, because some doctors, not all, think he can intubate, he can ventilate, so he can work alone in the NICU without any supervision and all of this, and it will be, there is lacking of the knowledge regarding the pathophysiology of the disease and the tips of the mechanical ventilations, and he's not familiar with mechanical ventilation. So our aim just to how to overcome this, we need to work more, to train more, take courses more, read more, to reach it to the professionalism. What is this professionalism? Is good knowledge, good skills, and attitude, and to be safe, doctor. So if you don't have all of this, this means you can kill your patient. If you cannot know about the mechanical ventilations, and you cannot handle the baby on the high risk baby on the mechanical ventilations, so the end result, it will damage the baby, maybe lead to morbidity and mortality. Maybe you will kill your patient. If you're not kill your patient, actually it will be will affect the outcome, and maybe will disable, will be disability, will be higher, and neurodevelopmental outcome, it will be poor. So we are not concerning about the survival alone. We are concerning about survival with better outcome. The people now is not talking about the mortality, because the mortality is now with advanced technology, it will be less now. Like the people talking about the outcome. So survival with outcome is not survival alone. Survival with better outcome. This will affect. This is unit is good, or there is problem with this unit by the outcome of this unit. So our goal to be safe environment and safe doctor. How to be safe environment and safe doctor? To maintain sufficient oxygenation and ventilation to ensure tissue viability until the disease process has resolved. So just we need to maintain the oxygenation and ventilation to help the patient to overcome and to resolve the process and the illness of this patient. Another goal, it will help also the improve the gas exchange, the oxygenation and ventilation and CO2 and the pH, and maintain a range, provide safe environment for the patient while protecting the lung from damage during oxygen toxicity and pressure, maybe lead to barotrauma or tidal volume over distension lead to volutrauma or atelectrocytoma. So our aim to protect our patient, to be safe, safe doctor, safe environment, to protect the patient from the hazard of the mechanical ventilation, either ventilation or oxygenation. From ventilation and the trauma, barotrauma, volutrauma, and biotrauma, and atelectrocytoma and retrauma, and also to protect the patient from the higher oxygenation and the free radical. It will affect in the brain, and will affect in the eye, and will affect the lung. So our aim, safe environment, safe doctor. How to be a safe doctor and how to create safe environment for the your patients, to provide adequate oxygenation and ventilation with minimal intervention possible. Minimal. Sometimes you manipulate the patient, give it high pressure, it lead to barotrauma, or you give, you reset the pressure, but you don't know the volume, it lead to volutrauma, and volutrauma, barotrauma, it lead to biotrauma actually, and if low pressure, it's lead to atelectrocytoma. Also, our aim and goal to ventilate the lung also to minimize the risk of the lung injury. Otherwise, it lead to chronic lung disease, oxygen dependent, ventilation dependent, and will affect the neurodevelopmental outcome. Also, our aim to reduce the patient work breath, because we need to help to improve the minute ventilation. Minute ventilation is the tidal volume times the respiratory rate. So we need to decrease the work of the breathing, decrease the respiratory rate, and also improve the minute ventilation and to optimize the patient comfort. This is our aim. Also, our aim to improve the lung mechanics. Lung mechanics, as we know, time constant, it's equal the compliance time the resistance. So we need to improve the compliance and decrease the resistance. So if you improve the compliance and decrease the resistance, will improve the lung mechanics and will improve the work of breath and will improve the lung mechanics. This is our reference from mechanical ventilation, pediatric and neonatal mechanical ventilations. So the basic concept for mechanical ventilation, as we know, what is mechanical ventilation? Is air goes in and out the lung. It goes in is increase oxygen and goes out to eliminate the CO2. So the our aim from the mechanical ventilations, it's CO2 elimination and oxygen uptake oxygen uptake. And how to do this process, how to eliminate the CO2 through the alveolar ventilation, as we and minute ventilation. Minute ventilation is respiratory rate in the tidal volume. And alveolar ventilation, tidal volume minus dead space times the respiratory rate. It will be same. That just will add tidal volume minus the dead space. This will help to eliminate the CO2, increase the respiratory rate, if you improve the respiratory rate and improve the tidal volume, it will help to eliminate the CO2. And depend on your mechanical ventilation, is volume controlled or pressure controlled. Just you adjust or the volume control, you will preset the volume and the pressure, it will be variable. Pressure limited, you will set the pressure and the volume, it will be variable. The second issue actually will help the oxygen uptake. This is the oxygen uptake depend on the mean airway pressure. So the mechanical ventilation concepts, mechanical ventilation concepts actually, there is three concepts you have to put it in your mind. The first concept, the mechanical ventilation is harmful, can be harmful. Do you know the mechanical ventilation, it can be harmful? When the mechanical ventilation is harmful, if you are still not trained about the mechanical ventilations, if still you don't know the path of a surge of the disease, if still you cannot manipulate the sick patient on the mechanical ventilation, how it is be harmful? Actually, we know the mechanical ventilation induced airway injury. Mechanical ventilation induced thoracobronchial injury. Mechanical ventilation induced lung injury. Mechanical ventilation association with lung injury. Mechanical ventilation associated with infection, or we call it mechanical ventilation pneumonia, or we call it VAP, ventilation associated pneumonia. So this is all the complication of mechanical ventilation related to the lung. It can be extra pulmonary, so it will affect in the brain, it will affect in the eye, it will affect the path of surgery of the patient, all it even can affect of the blood pressure. So you have to know the mechanical ventilation is harmful, so we need to manipulate it very well. You have to understand it, how to deal with it. The second issues, do you know the mechanical ventilation is work against the physiology? It can work against the abnormal physiology. Yes, because the normal physiology, it's actually is negative pressure. It will create increase intra the air, it will pull through, increase the intra thoracic pressure, increase intra pleural pressure, increase intra respiratory pressure. So the air comes from the atmosphere to go to through the airway, then it will go to the lung. The mechanical ventilation is pushing the air, because positive pressure ventilation is pushing the air against the airway resistance, against the elastic pressure in the lung. The third issues, do you know the mechanical ventilation, is it supportive therapy, is not curative? As we know, just the mechanical ventilation is temporary, just to help your patient to overcome the illness, to overcome the disease. Then it's not curative, just only temporary period until to save the patient during the compromising time. So you have to know the mechanical ventilation is harmful. You have to know the mechanical ventilation is work against the mechanical against the physiology, because it's pushing the air, not pulling the air like the normal spontaneous breathing. You have to know it is supportive, not curative, just to overcome and to help the patient during his illness. And this is the injuries. It will be barotrauma due to high pressure, high beep, high MAP. Also, how can the mechanical ventilation harm the patient? Through the minute ventilation. Minute ventilation respiratory rate, if you increase the respiratory rate, it can induce O2 beep. And if you are increasing the tidal volume, can induce O2 beep and decreasing the cardiac pressure and the venous return, and can affect the cerebral perfusion. And also the beep, if you are increasing the beep, it lead to barotrauma and decrease the venous return and decrease cardiac output and can lead to hypotension. And if you're decreasing the beep, it lead to atelectatic changes, oxygenation also, it will oxygen toxicity, it will affect the brain and the eye and the lung. So this is the basic mechanical ventilation. Will continue the mechanical ventilation indications and other parts of the mechanical ventilation. شكرا, السلام عليكم.